My dear sisters and brothers of the Pilgrim family, it's a joy to be with you today as we together celebrate the Day of Fidelity as daughters and sons of Padre Pio. And as we go through the events of this day, renewing our fidelity to God in the way of Padre Pio as his daughters and sons, I'd like to share with you just a little reflection from the Gospel of last Sunday. When John the Baptist sees Jesus coming towards him for baptism, he would say to his two disciples, "Behold the Lamb of God who takes away the sins of the world." And the two disciples from then on would follow Jesus. And as they go walking behind him, shadowing him, Jesus would turn around and ask that important question, that pertinent question, that question that matters the most in our life. He would say to them, "What are you seeking?" In other words, "What do you want? What do you expect from me?" As we go through the scriptures, the New Testament in particular, we see Jesus raising this question to those that come into contact with him time and again. "What do you want from me? What do you expect from me? What do you want me to do for you?" And so, as we celebrate the Day of Fidelity today, it may be good to ask ourselves, "What am I seeking? What am I looking for? What do I want from life?" Sisters and brothers, this can be a very spiritual question, a question that goes to the core of who we are and what we are called to be. What do I want from life? What are you looking for? And sitting with this question, I realize that it actually gives rise to three other questions. The first being, what are you working for? If only you could answer this question in all honesty. Are you working for money? Are you working for power? Are you working that you may have honor and glory? Or are you working for comfort? Or for pleasure, or just for the sake of it? What are you working for? What am I working for? What is it that drives me? What is it that motivates me? Again, in a nutshell, what am I working for? The second question is, what am I resting in? At the end of a day's of hard work, how do I treat myself? What do I feed myself with? What is a TV channel that I go back to time and again? What's a newspaper that I try to read and feed myself? It is said, you are what you eat. And it can also be stretched to say, you are what you feed yourself with. And so the question, what do I rest in, becomes all the more important. And so the first question, what am I working for? And the second question, what am I resting in? A silly example. Those of us that are familiar with cooking will know the concept of marination. I do that time and again because it is that process of marination that actually adds flavor to the food that we prepare and renders our cooking a success. And the food turns out to be flavorful, enjoyed, and relished by those that bite into it and chew on it. Marination. That's what I would call resting in. And so the question, what are you resting in? in God, in the world, in politics, in this channel, in this newspaper, or in this company of friends. We are the company we keep. We become what we eat. And so the question, what am I resting in? And that brings us to the third question. What am I living for? In other words, what are the values that I stand by? What are the principles that guide me? What are the beliefs that make me who I am? My dear sisters and brothers, the simple question from Jesus, what are you seeking? What are you looking for? What do you want from me? Gives rise to these three questions. What am I working for? What am I resting in? And what am I living for? I hope, as daughters and sons of Padre Pio, you and I will spend a few moments with these questions. And looking upon Padre Pio, what would be his answer to the first question? What am I working for? In short, it is this: for the greater glory of God and for the salvation of souls. That's what he was working for, all the time for God and with God and under God, so that he could save souls day after day after day. And that is why he would be always resting in God, in prayer, in penance, in contemplation, in the Eucharist that he celebrated with so much of fervor and devotion. And finally, that last question, what is it that Padre Pio was living for God? It takes us back to the first question. He was living for God, who wanted to save souls. And so, let us sit with these three questions in all honesty and sincerity of heart. And may Padre Pio lead us on to be honest to ourselves as we stand before God, as we go through this day of fidelity. Padre Pio, pray for us.